Welcome everybody to another tutorial on the BBoneDust channel. Today we're going to do a tutorial from the Scum game, and it's about cooking some meat. So I've actually done recording before, but didn't record my microphone, so we're doing another one. I put up the fireplace, put up this grill, improvised grill. Craft it over here somewhere, down here, and the fireplace here. Can also use this one. Yeah, let's dig into it. How to make some meat. I've got some meat on me, so we'll start the fireplace up. So there's several ways you can do it. We're going to do it with putting the meat straight on the ground. You can do that with no issues at all. It's not going to get dirty or stuff like that. You can actually eat it with no problems at all. So we're going to put it down. The thing you have to remember is to not put the meat too close to the fireplace, because if it gets too much heat, it's going to spoil pretty fast. So put it out here. I want to turn it a bit. You can turn it while holding down shift and mouse scroll. Put it like here at the beginning. Take this up, right click it, and say check taste. So now it's warm. Give it 4 seconds, 4 or 5 seconds to update the heat before you move the meat. So we come to move the meat because warm is not good enough. We want it to get hot. We don't want it to get burning, because then you're going to spoil the meat. So wait some seconds, it still stays warm, move the meat, like that. And right click it. It will also change the sound from the meat. It's like it's going to boil, making some kind of boiling sound when it gets to the hot, but also to the burning stage. So still stays warm. We're going to move it just a little bit. And be aware of the sound. 3, 4 seconds. Check taste. Still warm. Move it a bit. 1, 2, 3, 4. Still warm. 2, 3, 4. It still stays warm. The thing is, if you want to put some more fuel on the fireplace, you need to pick this one up. We're going to do that just to get it really good burning. Let's chop this tree down. Just to show you. So the range of the heat will expand. So be aware of that. So if you've got meat down on the ground and putting some wood on it, we will have to be aware not putting too much wood on it. We're going to just, yeah, let's take this one. Oh, we actually got one down here, I think. Yeah, I'm actually using long sticks. It's the best way, I think, to do it, because they're not going to put too much heat on. And if you're going to use a log, it's going to put way too much heat. So we can do, pick this up, take in hands, and F key and fuel fire with a long wooden stick. Just like that. Let's take one more. There we go. Alright, let's try it again. Find some meat, put it down like here. Let's have a look. Check taste, it's warm. Let's move it closer. Wait 4 seconds. Still warm. Move it further. Wait for it. Warm. Move it a bit further. Yeah. Now I'm going to do a half meat like this. Yeah. Did you hear that? It changed the sound of the meat. So we're going to check taste, and it's hot. And beware of this health, if you can call it that, durability on the meat. If it's going down, it's too hot. Let's just say it's 98. So the distance is really good now. And it says hot. So it's fine. So that's a way to do it on the ground. You can put more meat on now. Just put it to the side, like this. And should actually be okay. Remember to be aware of the health bar on the meat not going down. Right click, check taste, it's hot. 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 And hot. So it got like this like kind of spare heat range on this fireplace. You just go around if you want to do that. Just like to put it in a line like this. The thing is, when you are doing meat like this, you can actually, it's only going to take one slot if you're going to take it with you when you're traveling around the map and want some meat. So you can actually take, one meat is actually giving you a really good amount. So, 2 pieces of meat I would recommend, and it only takes 2 or 8 slots in your inventory. If you're going to do this, you're going to do a quiver. Go away. You can do this with a quiver. Let's have a look. No, not a quiver. What is it called? It's called why can't I find it? Skewer. Sorry. Where is it? We have to make it. Three pieces of meat. It's somewhere up here. Skewer, it's up here, yeah. So you need 3 long sticks to make that, and a knife. We're going over here, we can craft it. Just have to wait. Now we can craft the big one. If you want to do the small one, you only need 1 long stick. We can do that. Over here, let's check the meats. It's still okay. Nice. Check taste. It's hot and it's raw. So, with this one, as you can see here, it's a stick with 3 pieces of meat on. You can pick it up, and it takes, yeah, if you take the big slots, it takes 1, 2, 3, 4 big slots. You can hold it in your hand and stand close to the fireplace and cook it like that. So it tells me it's warm. It's going to take time. You can also put it down on the ground like this. Take it out, turn it around with the mouse scrolling, and turn this way. So it's the same. Right click, check taste. So now it's warm. Wait 4 seconds. It's still warm. Then you move it just like the other ones. Check taste. So now it's hot. Look up there. It's falling. So move it away. It's too close. So we actually burned it a little bit. Move them all away. Don't know why it keeps telling me it's too hot. So, as you see, we were too fast when moving it too close, so we really have to pay attention to that. Let's move it a little bit, like this. It says me warm, wait 4 to 5 seconds. Don't rush it. I did that, I rushed it, and it was getting too close. So now it's hot. Look at that, it took around 5 seconds before it updated that. And it's not dropping. And it's hot. And it's raw. So, yeah. That was with 3 pieces of meat, and then you got this one. You have to craft this first, and then you can go in here and craft this with 5 pieces of meat on it. Craft it. Pick it up. And put it down. What do we got? It's, so it takes a lot more of room. Look at that. Double as much as this one. And if you want to run around with this one, it takes, what was it? 4 slots. And this one takes 8, so that's huge! Only for 5 pieces of meat. If you only take them as the single ones, they take almost half. So that's why I don't like these ones. But it's the same. You can hold it in your hand, go close to the fireplace, or you can put it down, like this. It's probably too close, I'm going to move it. Like this. And we wait 4 or 5 seconds. Check taste, it's warm. Wait some more. Still warm. Okay, let's move it a little bit. Remember to wait. Don't rush it. Or you're going to spoil it. Remember to pay attention to this number up here. Still tells me it's warm. Let's move it a little bit. Check taste. Is it going down? Nope. Still tells me it's warm. Let's move it a little bit. Not too much. Now it's hot. And let's wait 5 seconds to see if it's getting more than hot, because it can do that. It can go burning. It stays there. Nice. Check taste on this one. It's warm. So we actually need to move that, or we need to put some more fire on. This one is cooked now. This one is cooked. Hot and cooked. Hot and cooked. So you can actually put some more fire, some more wood on, but remember to pick these up before you do that, because you're going to burn it. This one is not, it's only warm now, so we actually have to move it a bit because it's using the fire up. Now it's hot again. Remember to pay attention. 70-70. So with this one you can actually use a grill. Let's put it up here. Again, remember in the center of the fireplace is the hottest space, so start out here. I'd like to turn it a bit. Start out here in the corner. Like this. And wait. Check taste. It's warm. If you put it into the center, it's going to be too hot in the beginning. Wait the 5 seconds. Still warm. Let's move it a bit, like this. nice warm. Perhaps now I'm rushing it, I don't know. Don't hear any change in the sound of the meat, so let's move it a little bit. Oh, I heard something. Is it this meat? I don't know. It's hot, yeah. So that's it. Put it up there. Keep an eye on it. All of it, you have to keep an eye. You can't just put it on and leave it. So, oh, this one is burnt. Look at that. It just got burnt because I didn't pay attention to it. So, we really have to pay attention to your meat. This one is hot and still raw. It's crazy, this one is actually burnt. So yeah, it got too long. It got too much heat and it was actually cooked, and if I didn't take it off, it's going to get burnt, and that's what's happened. So pay attention of that. Slightly cooked, you can actually eat it now. You can just use the icons up here and check the taste on those, like this. This one is still hot. This one is slightly cooked, still hot, so it's fine. Yeah, and that's it. That's how to do it. But I would recommend the single pieces of meat. Where are they? What? Let's have a look. Check taste. This one is raw. We don't want that. Check taste. This one is cooked. So check taste and up here so you can figure out what is cooked and what is raw. So I would recommend to run around with single pieces of meat because they don't take so much space in your inventory. It takes a little bit more time to cook. And it's a little bit more tricky to control. But I really hate this one. Takes so much space. Look at that. It's crazy. For 5 pieces of meat. Nope, I don't want that. I don't want that to run around. But hey, if you got a lot of meat and just want to eat at the fireplace instant, these are probably the best way to do it because I think they are faster and easier to control with a lot of meat. But normally you just need one meat to eat. There's a lot of proteins in that one. So let me see, am I hungry? No, I'm not actually. Stomach is not full. Let's eat one. Let's say eat all, and let's see how much it fills up my stomach. It almost fills a totally empty stomach up, so that's just for one piece of meat. So yeah. That's it. Hope you like the tutorial and you can use it for getting started in the Scum game. It's really nice. It's a bit tricky, but you can do it. So if you like the video, put the thumbs up and perhaps a follow. I would appreciate that. See you until next time. Bye bye.